Good readings and good day, no matter where you are or what part of the world you are in. I hope that you are having a good day. So the question today is he good for you? Is she good for you? Is this the right person? That person that called you with a good morning, that text you good morning, called you good night, or text you good night, or that you just went out on a date with, or that you're currently dating, or that you've been married to for 20 years, whatever it looks like, is that the right partner for you? So, thank you, Spirit. Please protect me as I read these cards, and please give me the truth. Thank you. If it doesn't apply, let it fly, y'all. Okay, let's see. Let's see if we can get a yes or no. So, this fell out on the floor. I don't know if it came out in the reverse or the upright. But it's the Nine of Pentacles. So let's see. What's our yes or no on that Nine of Pentacles? Nine of Pentacles? I want to say Nine of Pentacles is a yes, but I always like to confirm. I guess I'm doubting myself. And we do that. So. It is a yes. Okay. But then this Queen of Swords came out in the reverse. So let's see. Sorry, y'all, it popped right up before, but now it's not, it is someone careless, cruel, harsh, dangerous, and cold-hearted. So, bitter, narrow-minded, insincere, and intolerant. So, I'm going to say that maybe this came out in the reverse. Because the Queen of Swords is saying that basically this is a feminine energy, male or female. It's a feminine energy that is overly emotional, deceitful, easily influenced, bitchy, cold-hearted, cruel, bitter, narrow-minded, insincere, and intolerant. So, if you allow this person to come back into your life, that's what you're going to get. And like I said, I'm going to assume that maybe the Nine of Pentacles came out in the reverse. So perhaps you are afraid, and you're wanting to feel confident. Right now, you may be living above your means, whatever that means for you. Living above your means could just be, you know that your paychecks need to go towards your bills, but you still eat out or still, you know, pop bottles or whatever that looks like. It can mean that it can mean different things to different people. Because sometimes even the simplest things that we don't think to consider are some of the things that we maybe need to do a little different. But there is deception coming from that person. And they may make you feel like everything's going to work out and everything's going to be fine, but... didn't realize the death card. The death card flipped over. So that definitely means it needs to come to an end. And I don't think I need to say anything else. Let me get an oracle message. I don't think I need to say anything else. That's it. That is it, and that is all. I'm going to read the Black Goddess Within Oracle deck today. Sage it a little bit. This is a very small deck, so let's see which one we get. Looks like they want to come out. Maybe these maybe no message wants to come out today. Maybe I need to get my okay. One came out. I'm gonna read a crystal card too. These have had some clear quartz on them, so, but I'm gonna sage them anyway. That in a second. And I'll show it to you. One more time. sometimes I can do the bridge and sometimes I can't. So sometimes I don't even try. All right. What gemstone do we need to be using right now in order to clear this energy? Tanzanite. Okay. This is the Ma'at card. That's the back. And this is what it looks like on the front. See how powerful she is? And pyramids in the background. The goddess of truth and justice, Ma'at, reflects our own brilliance back to us. So, as a man is or thinketh, so he attracts. So, if you're thinking that all men are dogs or women ain't, you know, worth your time and effort, then that's why this person is still showing up in your life. You have to be confident and love on yourself and know that you deserve to have the type of person that you want. Through this effort, she reminds us to look at ourselves carefully so that we may truly know where our growing edges lie as we step into our greatness. Unleash your unstoppable. Again, you need to have confidence in yourself. And the strength and the willpower to push forward and do the things that you need to do for your mind, body, and soul, as well as your finances. And then the healthy relationships that you're desiring will come. Or the whatever type of relationship you would like. Okay. Ready to love again. Okay. You've healed from the past enough to open your heart to new love. Okay, so this seems like it's an old person again that came back, called all of a sudden out of the blue, that you just went out on a date with, that text you good morning, called you good night, that you've been in a relationship with for 20 years, that did I say went out on a date with again? Whatever that situation looks like, y'all had the person you maybe had argument with, whoever you're thinking about, whoever's on your mind, male or female, in the current situation is not the right person for you. Now, if you have more than one person, or if you're thinking about dating new people, yes, you're ready. Your heart is ready. Your heart is ready for new love, not this, but something new. So embrace the something new. I know sometimes we don't like to change. We get used to what we've had or think, oh, because of all these years or whatever that looks like. And I know I've said that before in previous videos. But you're unstoppable. So unleash your power. You see how powerful this card is? You see her? Look at that stance. And she's standing in concrete. Those wings. Look at the wingspan. The crown on her head. That's not concrete. That's rock is what I meant to say. Rock. Solid rock. She was able to dig her feet into the solid rock. That is power. Use the power within you. We all have that power within us. We just have to tap into it. We've suppressed it and pushed it back and told us ourselves we don't deserve this or deserve that. So now you've already started doing the work. Now it's, you know, now it's time for you to open up to the new love that you're supposed to receive. Now that new love could be coming from an older person, but also a person who has also healed themselves, or at least begun the healing process, and is open to continuing to heal and grow with you. But if this person has never even attempted to do anything to heal, not even read an article, then this is that other person who, that situation, this is the death card. That situation just needs to come to an end. Endings, it could be beginning, so sometimes, as they say, when one door closes, another one opens. Embrace the change. Change is okay. Sometimes change is good. A lot of times we don't like the change, but then it ends up being better than the previous situation or person, whatever that looks like, or place, if you're moving, if that's your situation. So maybe you need to sever a relationship with a landlord or a homeowners association. It's transformation though. So again, this card is telling you you've done the healing, so it's okay for you to transform. It's okay for you to let out the old and let in the new. It's okay. And Kenyatta, if you're watching this, Renovation Wellness Spa, she has a massage studio. It's okay for you to drive that Benz, boo. I'm proud of you. Okay? It's okay. Nobody else has to be proud of you. I'm proud of you, and you should be proud of yourself. And that's just for her. Shout out to Kenyatta, again, Renovation Wellness Spa, in College Park, Georgia, or Atlanta, Georgia. Okay? So, that's her website too, renovationwellnessspa.com, if I'm not mistaken. If I'm wrong, I apologize, and I'll change it in the description box. But yeah, it's okay. It's okay for you to do what you need to do for yourself. So sometimes that transformation is, hey, it's not bragging, but it's being proud of your accomplishments and the things that you've achieved, and rewarding yourself in a way that you feel is beneficial to you. And so if that means buying you a BMW, a Mercedes-Benz, a Lexus, a Chevy Impala, if that is what it means for you, then it is wonderful. Because everybody doesn't want luxury cars, and everybody doesn't want designer clothes, and everybody doesn't want diamonds or whatever. Some people just want, a more simpler life where, they shop at whatever their favorite store is, and it may not, again, sell designer clothes, but they're just satisfied with having clothes and providing for their children, maybe having a car, maybe not, but having a home. And so that's their sense of security, and protection, and that's just fine with them. And there's nothing wrong with that either. But again, there's nothing wrong with change either. So if somebody wants to stay the same or live a simple life, that's fine. But if somebody wants to grow and elevate to a higher level, that is also fine too. So don't allow anyone to get in your ear and say, "Oh, you think you're better than me," or "Oh, you think you this," or "You think you all of that." And 'cause I've heard of, things like that too. It's because people don't like change. But again, a lot of times change is good. It's transition. So you may have actually lost a loved one. I did lose my Nana. So it does represent transition, metamorphosis, so healing. So again, you started this healing journey, and you went from the little worm to the butterfly. You've gone through your steps, you've gone through your stages, And so change is going to come. It's inevitable, no matter what. Those are the two things that are inevitable, really. And that's basically what the death card represents. Change. Something's always going to come to an end, or a new beginning is going to start. And death. Physical, actual, literal death. We know that things are going to change, and we know that things are going to die. Plants, animals, you know, beings, the grass, the sun goes away, you know, at night, and the moon goes away during the daytime. So, you know, it's just change, though. It's just changing from one to another, from day to night. It can also represent the end of a cycle. Okay, and the end of the cycle may be the end of the relationship with whoever this person is. Whoever this Queen of Swords, male or female energy is, who's overly emotional, deceitful, easily influenced, bitchy, cold-hearted, cruel, bitter, narrow-minded, insincere, and intolerant. And it's causing this fear, insecurity, this person to live beyond their means because they're trying to do too much, keep up with too many women, keep up with too many men, whatever that looks like. They give you a false sense of security because they'll come in as if they're going to do all these different things and they're lying. That they're deceptive. And so you don't have faith in this person because you can't trust this person. And so you need to put an end to that situation. And you yourself have already started your healing journey. And you need to get you some Tanzanite. Okay? So that you don't even think about this energy. And the Neteru Ma'at. Again, it's truth and justice. So you want someone honest. Now who's going to bring in this energy? You want the honest. It's truth and justice. The goddess of truth and justice. Ma'at the Neteru of Egypt is the goddess of truth and justice. Ma'at reflects our own brilliance back into us. And that's how come you know this energy is a little bit off. And that's one of the reasons why you had to ask the question or were curious about this person. Is this the right person? No, this isn't the right person, but you're the right person. Get you some Tanzanite because you are ready to love again. It's clear that you're ready to love again. You've healed, you've passed your test. And of course, we'll still have, you know, continue to have things come up for us. But you've come a long way, baby. Okay? And you're ready and open to find that right person. And that's how come you may not know exactly what's going on, but you can pretty much pinpoint, yeah, there's something not right about this person. And that's why you're wondering and questioning and having to ask. Because sometimes people can pretend for a really long time, but deep down we understand and know the truth. Okay? Just remind yourself that you've grown. And you're stepping into your greatness, or you have already stepped into your greatness. So you're unleash your unstoppable. Keep going. Keep going. Okay? I love y'all. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share, and hit the notification bell if you would like to see more.